Hello everyone, I'm Ihsan. In this video, we'll see how to transfer WhatsApp data from Android to iOS. For the Android phone that we are using in this video is Samsung S21 Plus, and for iPhone that we are using is iPhone 13, which is on the right. Okay, now let's see how to transfer WhatsApp data from Android to iOS. For the first thing, you have to prepare to transfer WhatsApp data from Android to iOS. You must have a laptop or PC. And you must also have a USB Type-C cable and a lightning cable. If the laptop or PC you are using already has two USB Type-C ports, you can directly use USB Type-C to Type-C cable for Android and also Type-C to lightning cable for iPhone. Meanwhile, if you are using a laptop that still doesn't have two USB Type-C ports but only have USB Type-A, you must prepare a USB Type-C to USB Type-A cable for Android. Then you also have to prepare another cable for iPhone, which is USB Type-A to lightning. After setting up two cables for Android and iPhone that you are using, now you can immediately turn on your laptop. Then from the laptop or PC that you are using, you can directly open this link to download iCare Phone Transfer application. This iCare Phone Transfer application is an application that you can use to transfer WhatsApp data from Android to iPhone. Because so far there is no fast way to transfer WhatsApp data from Android to iPhone without using a laptop or PC. You can check out the link for iCare Phone Transfer application in the description of this video. After opening the link in the description of this video, you can directly download iCare Phone Transfer application. There is also a macOS version which you can click below. And you will immediately be able to download macOS version from there. Because here we are using Windows 11, we will return to the Windows version and we can immediately click free download. After successfully download it, you can directly install the application. Then when it appears like this, make sure you have checked this one. And then you can directly click install. The installation settings are also listed below to determine another installation path. Then here's also agreed to participate in the customer experience improvement plan. If you don't want to participate in this plan, you can uncheck this option. Then you can directly click the install button and then wait until the installation process is complete. After the application is successfully installed, we can immediately click the start button. Next, we can connect the cable that we have prepared for Android and iPhone. Because we want to transfer WhatsApp data from Android to iPhone, so first we have to connect the Type-C to Type-A cable from Android phone to the laptop. All you have to do is plug in the USB Type-A to your laptop and USB Type-C to your Android phone. Then when a pop-up message appears, you can click OK. And now on your laptop, you can see the application already detect your Android phone. Here you can see the brand name and also the version of your smartphone series. And the source has already matched, so let's select Samsung. And now let's directly plug in the cable for the phone transfer destination. Here we use iPhone 13 for the transfer destination. Now we will plug in the USB Type-A cable to the lightning port on iPhone. First, let's plug in the USB Type-A cable to the laptop, then connect it to iPhone 13 as well. And when connecting the cable on your iPhone, an option like this will appear. Then click Allow on the left. And when a pop-up notification appears, click Trust this computer. Then you just enter the passcode from your iPhone. And now in the application that you open on your laptop or PC, Samsung S21 Plus has been directly selected for the source of data. And for WhatsApp transfer destination, the one on the right is iPhone 13. Because the destination is in accordance with what we want, we can click the transfer button at the bottom. Then the next step, you can enable USB debugging on Android phone that you are using. First, make sure the USB setting for the connection have been selected for file transfer like this. Then to activate the USB debugging feature on Android phones, you can go to the smartphone settings, then scroll to the bottom and select about phone. Then here select software information. And you just have to tap 7 times on the build number section quickly like this. And at the end, sometimes you will be required to enter the PIN number of your Android phone. You just need to enter the PIN and it will say developer mode has been turned on. After the pop-up message developer mode has been turned on shows up, you can go back and in the smartphone settings at the bottom, you will now find the developer option feature. Then you just need to go into this developer option mode and activate the USB debugging feature. You can scroll and then find the USB debugging feature that you can activate right away. Then just click OK at the bottom. When a pop-up notification appears like this, you can select Always Allow from this computer and click Allow at the bottom right. Then in case that you have WhatsApp data on your iPhone, you can first backup the data before starting the transfer. Or if you still don't have any WhatsApp data on your iPhone, you can just click Continue. Then you can directly click the transfer button below. Then in the next step, when a display like this appears, you just have to enter WhatsApp on Android. Then you can click the options in the three dots option in the upper right corner. Then go to the WhatsApp settings and select chats option. In the chats option, you can click on chat backup at the bottom. And here you can first backup WhatsApp data on your Android phone by clicking the backup button. Then wait until the backup process is complete. After the backup process is complete, click on select backup history. Here we can select the most recent backup at the top and click continue. Then in the next step, you need to enter the phone number that you use on WhatsApp. Here you just need to put the phone number for the WhatsApp account. Then click the verify button. If you have activated this two-step verification on your WhatsApp account, you must first disable it for the verification process in order to backup WhatsApp data in this application. You can check in the WhatsApp and go to the settings, then select account. Then click on two-step verification. Here we haven't enabled this two-step verification just yet. So if your two-step verification feature is on, you must first disable it for this data transfer. Because here we have disabled the feature, we can click continue. Then here you can make sure that the phone number you entered is valid. And if it is already correct, you can click continue. Then you can directly check the message application on the smartphone that you are using with the WhatsApp number. Here the SIM card for WhatsApp number is on iPhone, so we can open the message application from iPhone. You can directly enter the verification code into iCareFone transfer application. And then click verify. Then you can directly log in to WhatsApp application on the iPhone that you are using and restore the data. You can first make sure that your iPhone has sufficient storage for the data, so that the transfer process can run smoothly. To check the storage capacity on your iPhone, you can go to the iPhone settings, then choose general menu, then select the about menu at the very top. And here you can find the storage capacity that you have on your iPhone. And you can check the available storage from this section. For example, here the capacity is still available 31 GB. So we can start restoring the WhatsApp data backup to this iPhone that we use. To restore the backup, you just need to open the WhatsApp application. Then you can click agree and continue. And just need to enter the WhatsApp number that you are using. And then click done button in the upper right corner of your iPhone. Then all you have to do is verify that the number you entered is correct. And click yes button on the right. During this transfer process, make sure you don't disconnect the cable that you plug into your iPhone and Android. And now you just need to enter the verification code sent to your smartphone based on the number you entered earlier. Then you just put the username from your WhatsApp account. And click done button in the upper right corner. Then to start the restore process on your iPhone, you need to disable Find My on your iPhone. You can go to settings, then select your account name and open the Find My iPhone menu. And here you can disable Find My iPhone feature for a while. Then just enter the password of your Apple ID. After successfully deactivating Find My iPhone feature, you can click try again on the laptop or PC that you are using. Here the iPhone will be seen restarting like this. And now when we check WhatsApp on iPhone, the WhatsApp data like photos and also voice notes have successfully transferred to the iPhone. So now you can directly use WhatsApp on iPhone with the chat data that was previously on your Android. And because the data transfer process has been successful, now you can unplug both cable on iPhone and Android. To transfer WhatsApp data with this iCareFone transfer application, you need a paid version. To use the paid version of this application, you have to pay around $19 for a subscription for a month. And if you use 30% discount coupon, you can get a 30% discount and you only need to pay around 235,000 rupiah. And the minimum subscription is unfortunately only for a month. And you have to use credit card or PayPal to pay for this application. For the monthly subscription, you can use it for 5 different devices. And you can use it for only one PC or laptop. And it already supports various devices such as iPhone 13 and also Samsung S22 series. So there are many smartphones that you can use for this WhatsApp data transfer. When we check on the official website, this application supports up to more than 5,000 devices. If you like this kind of video, don't forget to like and also subscribe so you'll be notified when there is a new video from this channel. If you have any questions or comment, you can write them in the comment section down below. Or you can also ask in our Telegram channel or directly DM us on our Instagram account @entertainment. See you in the next video.